You know, Osho had 93 Rolls Royces, and God, he had everything, you know. But I just want to mention to you that when I first heard his name, I made a decision to go and see him. And I had to get on a third class train, 3 hours outside of Mumbai, you know. That train was so crowded, even though I bought a seat, there was no sitting. I stood for 3 hours. And I jumped up and down for 3 hours trying to be alone in thousands and thousands of Indian friends. It was incredible. I got off that train and I couldn't find Osho. And I said to a guy in a bullock cart, he spoke pidgin English. I said, "Osho." He said, "Get in my bullock cart." So I got in the back of a bullock cart. And we, 45 minutes later, we were in front of Osho's house. Osho's house was one bedroom, one room. And I parked my bullock cart beside Osho's borrowed Chevrolet. He didn't have even have a car, you know. I didn't even have a bullock cart, I rented it. We were both in the moment, naked. I went to sleep out in front of his house because, you know, he was sleeping. And I had mosquitoes from the greater Mumbai area visiting me because I had had Greek yogurt and honey for breakfast. They knew I was a white boy. They were in love with me. And a young girl came and she gave me some Odomos, the worst smelling mosquito repellent in the history of time. It smells so bad. Now this, they made a better product now, by the way, Odomos, better now. But in my day, I didn't know if it worked on mosquitoes because they didn't like it, or they were like me, they didn't like the smell, you know? And they all disappeared, and then I was woken up to meet Osho, and the young girl said, "Oh, you can't meet Osho smelling like that. He's very sensitive." I spent 30 minutes trying to get rid of that smell in the shower. I came in to see Osho. It was so beautiful, and we had such a good time. And when I left him, that same girl that gave me the Odomos, the same girl that told me to take the Odomos off in the shower, the same girl that invited me to meet Osho, now she had a present for me. And that present was Seeds of Revolutionary Thought, the very book I read in Goa when I first became enlightened, you know. It now was written by Osho. And by the way, I just laughed because that's the miracle of India, you know. Very, very simple. Michael one step, Krishna Prem the next step. But now you can call me Michael, you can call me Krishna Prem. As long as you call me, I'm very, very happy. I'm pleased to share Osho with you, but it's not the Osho that had a long beard and beautiful eyes. It's the Osho that's just existence itself. When you have a cup of coffee and it feels good, when you smell a rose and it feels good, when you kiss a girl and it feels good. For me, that's Osho, you know. Existence itself saying, "Thank you, isn't it worth being alive?" It's worth being alive when you do meditate, when you do fall in love, when you have balance between meditation and the marketplace. Anyway, what to say? I'm happy. Thank you. Love.